Thank you so much for that wonderful speech, or I would like to say sharing a little bit of your book. I'm sure there are a lot of chapters which still people would like to read, but everyone out here has a lot of chapters in their lives. So I'm sure that will be inspiring. I could see comments coming in. There you are. It's coming down. She's from Imasha in the Sri Lanka. She's saying, congrats, Dr. Rita. There was someone else who wrote, sitting out here, I have actually multitasking between various halls and also ensuring that people get their due for which they have come in person or online. But before that, before we progress into a panel, this panel is even more confusing for me. I didn't know that I would be landing into a logistical nightmare. This is on the Be the Change You Want to See in the World, which Mahatma Gandhi said, and rightly so, the women have to answer that, because men, you know, are not really good people to answer that, because women usually have a stronger voice, a greater say, and as they say, the home minister, as they call them. But with due respect, I would first like to invite our chief guest for the morning. She has kindly consented to be here. Put your hands together for Advocate Anuradha Maheshwari, a legal expert, an IP expert. Ma'am, can you have you on stage? A little music for as Advocate walks up, a little awards music, please. Gentlemen, we need to have. And one thing, did you see? I never walked up on the stage because that's for you ladies, not for me. So I didn't step up on stage since morning. I have been speaking to you from ground level because that's what I think. Women, the stage is yours, so you'll grace it. I'll stand down and applaud as you walk up. No, you will be the sole presenter, you're the chief guest, please. Okay. Camera, is she on, correct? Is she properly placed? Camera, can you just signal me? Is she okay? All right. A few words and I'll get a few awardees. How you felt sitting through a few minutes despite your hectic schedule?
Yep. So thank you so much, Dr. Alok, and of course, Dr. Bhatia, for inviting me to this August gathering as well as this ceremony. It's always wonderful being a woman and celebrating women and achievements of women. I'm always reminded of Maya Angelou's very famous poem, Phenomenal Woman. You know, it says that it's the fire in my eyes, the flesh in my teeth, the swing in my waist, and of course, the joy in my feet. I am a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman, that's me. Many men wonder if it's me. So it's wonderful the way she has said, and it just resonates with all of us and all the achievers that are there today. And it'll be an absolute honor for me to, you know, give away the awards to the women who are here. It's a great, great inspiration. Dr. Rita, I'm most amazed hearing about your journey, and it's so awe-inspiring, really much to learn from whatever you have shared with us today. Great. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you so much, Advocate Anuradha. Well, we'll go in short spurts so that everyone gets a chance to click a photograph with you and also share the story. Our first winner for the morning is Ambassador Faith Hung Lin Lim. She's the Goodwill Ambassador to Singapore and the Chairperson for Sun Pho Global Federation, Women's Swing International.
Hi everyone. Thank you very much for this award. I think it is very important that all women stay empowered and we can do more for this world to make it become a better world for everyone. I would like to thank Dr. Alok and the jury and the committee for giving me this award. I would also like to thank Major General Dilawar Singh and Dr. Desha Priya for all their support all this while. Thank you. If not for so many people supporting me, I wouldn't have been able to get this award today. Thank you so much.
All right, next winner, Vidya Ramarajan, the head of human resources for ZF.
Morning all. I think it's a pleasure to be here amidst this August crowd and receiving it from a distinguished personality. Dr. Rita, you are really amazing. I mean, very inspiring indeed. I mean, I think looking at all of you, there's no end to what a woman can achieve, truly. And all of us have a long way to go. I thank my organization, my colleagues, my peers, management, and my family, of course, in the pillar of support if I have to be here today. Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Vidya. Our next winner for the morning is Shilpi Jain, the lead of corporate communications at IPE Global.
Hi, good morning. I'm Shilpi again, reintroducing myself. Thank you all for felicitating with the award. I must say it's nice to be paid to speak, okay? But it's even nicer to be felicitated and acknowledged for the work that we're doing. I thank the 9th World Women Leadership Congress, Dr. Alok, the jury, and the entire team behind for this award. And thank you all, everyone. It's a pleasure to kind of meet up with all of you. Let us as women, thank you, ma'am, to you as well. Let us as women, let us keep pushing ourselves to go beyond boundaries and make way for ourselves. Thank you so much.
Our next winner is Rupali Majgaonkar, Director of Marketing for Armstrong Machine Builders Private Limited.
Good morning, ladies. And good morning, gentlemen. This is indeed a great honor sharing this platform with all of you brave and wonderful ladies. And it also inspires me to do more and achieve better. And thank you, Dr. Alok and the Leadership Congress for this recognition. Thank you so much.
All right, the next winner is Maha Kalmul Al-Raisi. She's the AGM, Head of Products, Retail and Digital Banking from the National Bank of Oman.
Good morning, all. Dr. Alok, everyone here. I'd like to thank you, thank the jury, thank everyone for this opportunity and for being granted this award. Dr. Alok, when you spoke to me, I was really surprised, but thank you very much. Rita, Dr. Rita, your story is very inspiring. It just gives us the energy to just move on and keep doing the best that we can. Thank you all, and congratulations to everyone here as well. Thank you very much.
All right, Maha, please be on stage. Those who got their citations, can we have a group photograph? Let's add some color. Maha actually crossed paths with me way back in 2019 in Dubai. She didn't recall, but I had that email communication from 2019 and 2018. We have a very special award. This is for the exemplary woman leadership. And it goes to Manjari Chandra, the founder of Manjari Wellness and a consultant for Max Healthcare. Put your hands together for Manjari Chandra.
What a lovely morning. Thank you, Dr. Alok. Thank you, all the lovely ladies present here, and thank you, ma'am. I am by profession a doctor, but I practice something called functional medicine, which is not prescribing drugs, but using lifestyle to reverse diseases. And, you know, I work in Delhi, and I met Dr. Alok long back, and, you know, I was really surprised at what was happening. So glad to be here and to be part of this. Extremely inspired, Dr. Rita. I've met you before also. But I just want to say one thing here today that, you know, women's health, which is such a big priority today because they're trying to juggle too many things and somehow health takes a back seat. We are very informed, but putting it into action is still not happening the way it should be happening. What we see alarmingly today in our centers and hospitals and clinics is that this is manifesting into physical disease, which means more cancers, more PCOD, more hormonal imbalances, more nervous breakdowns, you know, more depression. So, I mean, there's really a lot to preventive health, and that's where I'm working, and I'm really glad to be part of everything that's going on here. Thank you, Dr. Alok. Thank you, everybody, and have a great day ahead.
Well, thank you so much. Well, thank you so much, ma'am, for doing us this first set of honors. Give a little respite so that they say use your resources optimally. I need to use that. So please be seated. Okay, it's been a wonderful morning so far. A little slow in picking up, but nonetheless, I can see more faces coming into the hall. Had it been a normal era, no pandemic era, if it had been, it would have gone a notch higher. When we last did our event in 2020, I had close to around 350, 400. Yeah, Vidya said so. Not people, women. So imagine my condition handling 450 women or 350 women in a hall and multiple. Pardon me? Oh, wow. My wife doesn't think so. She's very happy when I move out, so because she gets her time a little to do that, because she basically is into tarot and crystal healing, so she gets her me time because I'm not there to keep pestering her. And I also love meeting women, meeting people actually, because that's what keeps me going. I can see a wonderful face, Fatima, all the way from Ghana. We actually met way back in 2008 or 9. 2008 was when my first interaction happened. It's been 14 years and the relationship's still there. So we are just not into events, we're basically into relations. People come in touch with us and get bonded for life, irrespective of where life takes us. She even came to meet me in my office when she was on a short trip. She's here for a wedding of a celebrity. She was in a mehndi ceremony when I called her yesterday, and she took some time out to be a part of the event. She's going back for the marriage later this evening. So it's a huge wedding which is going on. So thank you so much, ladies, for being a part right now. We will now have a panel, and this is the most dreadful part for me. Handling a panel which is hybrid is really tough. I've never done that ever. So apologies if we have a little bit of hiccups, but still, we'll do it to the best of our ability. And one more thing, I'm working with the team who's currently sitting with me here. This is the first event in their life they're being a part of. There's nothing they have done. It's actually learning on their feet which they're doing. So all these youngsters you're looking at, they're hardly 6 months into my organization. So these are all, there are my pillars also sitting behind there, those young ladies. I've been blessed with having women working with me, not for me. So learning a lot in terms of they keep me grounded. All right, my first panelist, Shubham, can we get the first chair up on stage? Yeah. Would you like, Manjari, we have a few people online and few offline. How would you like to do that? Okay. We'll have Manjari is the first panelist. She's the consultant for function and nutrition from Max Healthcare. She just won an award. Manjari is on stage. Joining her would be Ambassador Faith Hung Lim. Ambassador. Guys, can you check if Aparna Lakshmi Singh has joined from Delhi?
Ma'am, this one's ready.
Please patch in Aparna Lakshmi Singh. For a chair. Please step up. I'll get another chair up. All right. Whom have you patched in? Bhavna has been patched in. Patch in Aparna, please. All right. Bhavna is in Bangalore.
Good morning.
Good morning, ladies. Is Dr. Shashi there from Mauritius? We'll just patch her in. Just look at the diversity and look at what logistics I have to undergo. Is Dr. Shashi online? Dr. Shashi Siv, sorry. She's online, patch her in. Please patch in Victoria Chukwu. I believe she is from Africa. Victoria, she's online. I think she's from Nigeria or Ghana, if I'm not mistaken. I think she's from Nigeria. Victoria, are you there? Patching her in. Patch in Emesha Pinto Jayawardene from Sri Lanka. She is the COO of Matrix Institute of Information Technology and the president of the Diversity Collective Lanka. Dr. Shashi is coming in. There she is. Who are we patching in now? Amisha has been patched. Just give us a few seconds for Amisha to come in.
Good morning.
All right, Amisha is in and Victoria is in. Can you patch? Is Anojita there from the Youth and Peace Activist from Jaffna, Sri Lanka? Nothing has been rehearsed. It's straight away on screen right now as we speak. Getting in. Okay, Victoria is just adjusting hers.
Good morning. Good morning. This is Victoria.
Good morning, Victoria. Please hold on. Be patient. Give me a second. Let me get in. Anojita Odashes.
Morning. Am I audible?
Please, you are. This was the favorite term 2 years and still goes on. Am I audible?
Yes.
I'm Dr. Shashi.
Dr. Alok, good morning.
Good morning, everyone. Now I will.
Good morning, Dr. Alok. This is Dr. Shashi from Mauritius.
Hi, namaste, Dr. Shashi.
Namaste, namaste. Happy to be with you all.
Would have loved to have you here in person.
Thank you.
I miss Mauritius. I miss Port Louis. And I miss the casino there. Okay, Dr. Manjari, your initial thoughts and let's start off. Everyone gets to speak for 2 minutes. Make it fair. I have got 7 people on screen, or 6 on screen, 2 here, 8. 8 into 2, 16 minutes. Just ensure that everyone speaks for just 2 minutes. And let me come back and see if the audience has something to share. Let's make it completely interactive. Let's change the whole definition of a conference. There are no solo speeches. Everyone interacts.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So thank you for starting with me. As I was trying to say before also, because I work in healthcare and I see a lot of women 20 or 25 years back when we started working, cervical cancers, PCOD was not the order of the day. I mean, when we were growing up, PCOD was not the order of the day. Young girls did not have hormonal imbalances the way they manifest now. So this is something that I've been thinking of for some time, and I started, you know, doing some work with it. And a group of us started researching on how the incidence of these lifestyle-driven diseases is rising in India in women. Because typically when we read medicine, we are told that women don't get so much affected by cardiometabolic illness because they have something called progesterone, a hormone that sort of saves them from cardiovascular diseases, from diabetes, hypertension, from hormonal imbalances, neurological disorders. But now it's rampant, and also cancer is rampant. And so when we did this small study and research, we realized that one of the main denominators why women are seeing more disease is the fact that although they are looked at as multitaskers and people who can juggle 10 things at a time, unlike men who have a flu and then have to be in bed for 2 days, but that is taking a toll, because what is expressing physically is psychosomatic in nature. And therefore, the correction for this has to go back to accepting that women are trying to achieve, but they haven't still been able to get the support system, as Dr. Rita was also mentioning, that can allow them to function and still look after themselves and everybody else at the same time. Somebody also spoke in the morning about having a full cup, because unless you have that, how do you sort of give out to people? And when you have an empty cup, when you have your own problems, it's very difficult to be fully giving. So I am really passionate about this. And so I started writing also. I just came out with my second book, which Rupa has published. And it's available in case you want to take it or pick it up. But basically, I really, really have a lot of passion about women's health. And I know it comes from the fact that they're trying to achieve, but society or the other sex in a way has not really woken up to that. And therefore, this conversation about other support and the support system and the other partner becoming equally responsible is something that I think has to become the order of the day, you know. And women have to, you know, become independent, but at the same time, they have to have support. And it's important because health is a very, very important topic today. So thank you. Thank you. I'll start with this and I'll pass it on to ma'am here.
Okay. Traditionally, women's role is really in at the family, because we have these nurturing characteristics. But I think in today's world, especially with COVID pandemic and this VUCA world, when things are so complex and there's a lot of unknowns, I think women characteristics of this nurturing characteristics, I think is very important today, especially when we are loving, because now a lot of people are under different levels of stress and depression because of a lot of issues, world issue, global issues that's being surfaced when after this COVID pandemic. So for myself, actually, I'm a very simple person. I used to think of, you know, like after graduating, I will marry and I'll have children. I'll bring them to the beaches over weekend. I never think that I will become who I am today. But I realized to impact the world and, bring more positive causes to this role, I need to showcase myself. I need to gain more skills and I can help more people. So after I was lucky that my master's degree, I got it like a decade ago. It was sponsored by the ministry. And after it things just rolled. And I took part in the pageant. It was actually just for fun, but I didn't know I was being crowned. And eventually I got a crown keeper title. That means the the title is Man for a Lifetime. And that was when I was being featured in an international magazine, and I was headhunted by my organization, so that I'm now heading the Women's Wing International, and we organize actually conferences to educate, inspire, and empower women. So for this year, we actually expanded the conference from one day to a one-week event, and we have a contingent from Nigeria, and we got like all the professional trainers to share online, especially now with globalization and technology advancement. People are so close together. We don't have to fly to the country. You know, everyone can get online and we can meet so easily. I think that's a good way that we can share with women who needs more empowerment. I think we are very privileged, all of us here, because we are empowered. I think that gives us a chance that we should help the other women who needs the platform to be empowered. So thank you, everyone. Yes, I hope everyone will be able to create a better future world. Together, we work hand in hand with the men. So my platform, actually, we also invite the men to come over. I think men and women shouldn't be divided. We should come together and collaborate. We actually have different characteristics. We should leverage on the strength rather than focusing what is the difference. We need to have diversity and inclusiveness. We can have collective wisdom. Then we will do things and of a bigger scale, and we can help even more. Thank you so much. Have faith, live your dreams, and live thy legacy.
Okay, from Malaysia, we move to the nation which is closest to Malaysia. Which one is that? We'll move on to, okay, I'll move on to Sri Lanka first. Can I have Imisha speak first?
Yes, thank you so much, World Women Leadership Congress and Awards 2022 for inviting me for this, and it's a great pleasure. Thank you so much, Dr. Alok, for inviting me. Yeah, so if you take the change, right, if you want to see the change in the world, I think first thing that you have to start from yourself, how much you love yourself, how much you want to change yourself for better. Because if you can't do that to yourself, you are not able to do it for others. So if you take the world, anyway, is changing every day, the war, and then you have famine and all these issues out there. So sometimes we have the, you know, I had this, I think somewhere around 2017, how can I do a change in the world? Then I'm thinking, can I do it alone? But you know, we can change one thing at a time, or one person at a time, one community at a time. So in 2018, I think more than being a COO, what I really like is being the president of Diversity Collective Lanka. So we started an association in order to promote diversity and inclusion, right, at workplace as well as in the community. And to be proud that we are the first association who started that in Sri Lanka to promote the diversity and inclusion. So for me, to be a change, what matters most is actually promoting D&I and also promoting the healthy life, as the doctor said, right? So the first thing is, if I take the diversity and inclusion, as you know, we started with the IT industry because I'm more connected to the IT industry. So we saw that there is a huge gender divide in the ICT industry, right? So if you take in Sri Lanka right now, in the ICT industry, it's about 29% participation of women, which is not really enough. So we started this Diversity Collective Lanka actually to promote more D&I initiatives in the ICT industry. But I'm happy to say now we are moving to other industries. We are moving to communities. We are doing more training programs to see this change. So early it was only 8 of us. We wanted to do the change, but now we have more than hundreds of people, you know, more than 20 companies aligned with us to do this change. Because we wanted to change ourselves, the way we think of the diversity in workplace, diversity in the community. So sometimes, for example, if someone says, the organization has a new CEO, the first question we will ask, from where did he come? So you can see that you are having unconscious biases. Because you ask he rather than ask whether it's he or she, right? because we always do that. So we want to get rid of this. You know, I want to see that change. And the second thing actually I want to see as a change is women are actually the warriors, right? So their contribution to the economy is really, really important. So if you want to contribute more, we should be really healthy in terms of our food, our lifestyle. So actually I started my own farm, small farm at home, somewhere in 2017, I started to grow my own food. As you all know, we are going through a little bit of crisis in Sri Lanka, but to be honest, I have no impact out of it, mostly with regard to the food, because I grow my own food and I started to blog about it, right? Because I was actually 90 kilos 4 years before, and to be honest, I reduced it to 74 kilos because of the lifestyle change and because of eating healthy. So if you want to change the world, first thing that you have to do is change it from yourself, not because of a forum, not because of advertising, not to showcase yourself, but from your inner mind, you need to do that change. So that's what I see that really matters. Thank you.
All right, we'll move on to Bhavna. Bhavna in Bangalore. Bhavna Mittal.
Hi, good morning. Good morning, Dr. Alok, and good morning, all the ladies on the panel and in this session. I should have been there in person, but I couldn't join in due to certain obligations here. I think this is a topic which is very, very close to my heart, given that, you know, we are now, it's only now that we're finding role models who women can emulate, because earlier it was very, very few role models which women had going into their personal lives, into their things. So you had like the Prime Minister of India, you had a few more politicians, a few actresses, but they were not really any good role models for women in the corporate world. It's only now that people like Indira Nooyi have, or maybe a Kiran Shaw have started coming in, for women to actually know that they can balance their work life and their personal life and still achieve what they want to be. And the best thing we can do as women here and who have achieved certain things in our life is to be role models for the women who we are hiring in our teams, for women who are interacting with, to tell them that, you know, things are achievable, you can do what you can. And it's when you decide that you don't compromise. So, to give you a very personal example, I got married last year at the age of 45 when I found the right person and the right partner who could actually help me live my dreams and live my ambition. And I decided I will not go in for a traditional Indian setup wherein you get an arranged marriage and, you know, you settle in or you compromise on what you want. So Rohit has been a fantastic force behind me doing things which I've never done before, be it in my personal life or my corporate life. I've been able to take on an entrepreneurial plunge, get out of my comfort zone of doing what I was doing till the last 23 years of my corporate career in media and digital, and join Bert Labs as a chief growth officer, getting into various domains which, you know, you wanted somebody else to handle in your past organizations. So it's very important for us to challenge ourselves and find the right person to help us challenge ourselves so that we can actually, you know, get to understand our own potential and actually live beyond our limits. So I really think that there's, you know, nothing which is unachievable. And if tomorrow I can get a few, you know, girls to actually follow their dreams and not get bound into the societal pressures of marrying for the sake of it, I think my job is done. So that's all I have to say here.
All right, from India, let's move on to Dr. Shashi in Mauritius.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Dr. Shashi Yosel, head of cancer unit in
New Cancer Hospital and the Victoria Hospital in Mauritius. And thanks, Dr. Alok, for choosing me again and again, and you inspire me every year to do it better and better for our country. Mauritius is a small island with 1.2 million population, and it is called paradise for the reason health is free and education is free. So in that way, we have closed the gap between the poor and the rich, and we are trying our best, what we call one world and one health. So what exactly happened is, so we have a well-established cancer hospital, and all the chemotherapy and the radiotherapy all are given free of cost, not just the cancer treatment, the bypass surgery, transplant, are all available to all the segments of the population. Fortunately, because our population is small, we could attain this. But now, the big challenge is that we are getting a new cancer hospital with the new facilities, including the CyberKnife, which I work with 5 oncologists. Now we have 15 oncologists, so it will be sufficient for another 15 years. So I made the human power. What we need is just the training. The training is very easy. Just connect to experts abroad. Get them. And our youngsters are very bright and they learn it very fast, even the latest technique, including myself. I do learn because I learn car driving now at the age of 60. So it shouldn't be difficult, because when you can learn car driving, learning computer is much easier. You don't need the legs, right? You need only the brain and the hands, which is much easier. So I always tell that you never age as long as you adopt a healthy lifestyle. And first is the healthy lifestyle, which is very important. Keeping the exercises and ideal diet and a positive approach, which is extremely important, a holistic approach for the cancer treatment. And what exactly happening in Mauritius is we are able to do the basic thing, and for the expertise, we are sending abroad the experts. So what exactly I dream is to bring even the expertise to Mauritius. That's why simplest, we train the local doctors by the experts from abroad. And I've already made the global connectivity, as I have friends, a lot of friends in India, Mumbai, Bangalore, Delhi. They're all willing to help us and train us in the CyberKnife, which is very, very latest technology. And not only that, I have friends in Ireland and the US and all over. They're ready to come and train in other discipline of cancer treatment. So just by connectivity, we can make things very better. And this, once we do it in our country, globally, we had to expand to the other countries of Africa and as well as Asia. Actually, I'm born in Bangalore, and I know the health doesn't reach all the segment of population in India, not only in India. I studied in United States. Even in states, there are some poverty-stricken Americans. They do not get access to the treatment. My dream is one world, one health. I think everybody should get that privilege. And we need to work as a team, not just in our country. I start with our country and I expand to other countries and my homeland in Bangalore. Another one thing, this, my father, he brought us up that women are intellectually same as men. He was a professor, studied in the United States, and he excelled in educating the ladies. And he said, if women are independent, they can face a problem of any magnitude anywhere in the world. And this, once you accept that you're intellectually same and prove that you can work as them, then the gender inequality automatically disappears. And you raise from gender level to human level. Once you inculcate the human level, you enjoy the world better. You see good human beings all over the world, in all walks of life, and it just disappears. Men and women are complementary, all are human. So that's what we had to raise to that. And I thank once again for everybody for making this event very successful. And a lot of successful ladies, don't be competitive to men, be complementary and raise from gender level. to human level, then you enjoy seeing a simple person who is very human. And you enjoy this world better. And I thank once again the organizers and my family and my friends and the organizers in which the institute from the JSS, they're the Mysore Institute, for helping me to organize all this. Thank you once again, Dr. Alok, for everything you've done.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shashi. Same continent, Africa. We'll move on from Mauritius, we'll move on to Nigeria. Put your hands together for Victoria Chukwu, the MD and CEO of Diocese Global. Victoria, good afternoon. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. My name is Victoria Chukwu. Wanting to be a change, I'm from Nigeria, yes. So wanting to be a change in the world is something everybody should aspire to do. And then I started this initiative, Change Begins With Me, in Nigeria. And the initiative is all about changing, you know, an anti-corruption youth initiative. So the initiative is to help, you know, curb corruption, because we cannot stop corruption totally. And there was a time in Nigeria that Nigeria was having a very high corruption status around the world. So with the initiative, which was championed by the All People Congress, All People Congress, which is a political party, where the president belongs to, they were able to, was adopted by the National Orientation Agency, and we were able to minimize the effect of corruption, and Nigeria came down on the corruption list. So we've been championing changes, and the initiative is all about the young people, 16 years old to, 45, standing up and saying no to social injustice, bringing about a peaceful economy all over the world, or particularly in Nigeria, and also to ensure that we do not have violent protests against the government or against ourselves, you know, to ensure that we have peaceful communications between, because Nigeria is a very, we have so many tribes in Nigeria, up to close to 100 different languages, but the major four tribes are the Igbos, the Yorubas, the Hausas, and the South Southerners. So the belief is that we're one Nigeria, and so we don't want war or fighting in the country, and that's what we've been able to achieve so far for the past 8 years since the president was in office, despite the harsh effect of COVID-19 on the economy, and so many Nigerians wanting to travel, you know, to relocate. But with this, we've been able to create an awareness, especially with the young people, that you don't have to change your identity just to belong to a better place or a better country or a better nation. The change begins with you, begins with me. And then the slogan for that initiative is do the right thing. Right now, we're trying to get the recognition in Nigeria for this initiative, that's me. And we are working towards it on change.org. So if you have the time, you can go on change.org and sign a signature for us. And also, there's a mobile app on this technology that should be able to detect and report crime directly to the special police. So that app is what the Indian companies are actually doing for us. There's a Mastra Technologies and in India over there. And that's how Dr. Alok was able to understand that we started this initiative here in Nigeria. So it's very nice that I'm being recognized for this. And I hope that all of us can be that change in our very little corners, in our families, in our place of work, in anything we start. We should always be putting in our mind that we're affecting not just us, but we're affecting a larger community. People are looking at us, people are watching us, people are observing us, and that change has to reflect in the way and manner we, you know, do things, the way and manner we speak, the way and manner we relate with one another. So it has to be something that is edifying, something that's edifying, the way we speak, the way we relate, and for the general good, so that we don't have crisis in the world and stuff like that. So that's all the initiative is about. So I want to thank Dr. Alok for including me on this panel discussion as an awardee from Nigeria. Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much for the invitation and also for the music. I'm so blessed to be here because listening to the stories of my pioneers, especially women, it's always inspired me to do more in my work. Hello everyone. I'm so happy to meet you all. And I'm Anojita Swaskaran. I'm also a youth and peace activist based in Jaffna, Sri Lanka. And also I'm also being a member of Refugee Education Council, which is a council that part of Together for Learning campaign organized by Canada. Thank you for the opportunity to share my own reflection and my own learnings about how to be the change and also how to advocate for the change in the community. I'm a person who has directly experienced the Sri Lankan civil war and also have been challenged by the outcomes till today. I have faced many difficulties even in getting access to education, food, justice, in many other things. And even after the war, I had kind of a, you know, inferiority complex because I observed many differences in between my school friends and myself because of war. I have lost few months to study and to, you know, develop my own potential. So I could able to sense the differences between my school friends and myself. So I thought that, you know, I'm a person who can't do anything, who can't speak English. And, I'm a person who can't even, you know, talk in front of people. But, you know, with the support of my family and my mentors, I could able to slowly develop myself. So I think what is more important to be the change and to advocate change, we have to be ready to express ourselves, learn new things, and also to be ready to kind of involved in community works as a volunteer. That is how I, as an individual, I, as a young person, become to a position that I'm here today. So the first thing is we have to be ready to express ourselves. Sometimes we think that father is the only person who can take decisions in our family. Father is the only person who can handle all these finance and all the house administration works, and we can't do that. And father is the only person who can take good decision for the family. And in classes also, we think that first benchers are the people who can, you know, take high ranks in the studies, and we are not the people who can do that. But it is not like that. There is no defined roles or defined designation for people. If we have the courage, we can be the leaders of tomorrow. That is what I learned from my my journey. For an example, we always have to have the courage to learn new things, because especially learning a language would, you know, brings more people into your life, bring more connections into your life, and also brings more opportunities to your life. So as a person from Northern Province, we usually speak Tamil. And also the community around us also always speak Tamil. And when I got an admission to a university which is in the southern part of Sri Lanka, there are like people and the community itself speaking a different language, I actually had a kind of a fear, and I really don't want to go there. But you know, my mother encouraged me and I went there and I started to learning the language that they are speaking. And, you know, that brought me new friends from all over the country and also from all over the world. And I started to learn English and also I started to learn Sinhala as well. So those two languages brought many opportunities into my table. So I think learning a new thing would never let you go down. It always, you know, higher up your level. And also as a in Sri Lanka, we have many problems in terms of ethnic conflicts and social, you know, social violence and all. But as a person from Northern, and also I am trying to, you know, help people, and I'm trying to help people to bridge the gap between among them by, you know, helping them to communicate with each other as a person who can speak all three languages. So I used to narrate the stories of my experiences, and I also give space for people from other community to talk about their experiences and what they have been going through. So these kind of storytelling and the, you know, and being an active listener always help us to bring the new connections and new understanding among us. I think that is how I became a young peace builder in this country, and I'm, you know, striving to achieve peace by empowering other fellow young people all around the world, not just in the country. So I think I just want to leave this topic with a quote that is said by Ban Ki-moon, that as the young leaders of tomorrow, as the women, as the people who are going to lead the world tomorrow, you have the passion and energy and commitment to make a difference. What I would like to really urge you to do is to have a global vision. Go beyond your country. Go beyond your national boundaries. So this is what he said. We have to always think ourselves as global citizens, and also we have to always try to you know, work on how we can contribute to this community to, you know, to bring a better future for next generation tomorrow. I think that is what this global pandemic also taught us. Let's think as a global citizens, and then we can make the change in this world. So thank you so much for this opportunity.
Thank you, Anujita. Thank you, Aparna, for applauding. The time is yours now. Aparna, can you hear me? Aparna Singh, you are still on mute. Aparna, unmute yourself.
Yes. Yes, doctor. Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, all ladies. Thank you, Dr. Alok, for inviting all of us and for giving us this platform. And as Anujita just said, we are global citizens. And this sisterhood we have on account of the World Women Leadership inviting us all together. And I'm so thankful for that. When we're talking of the change and the change that we want to see in the world, it is a certain leadership responsibility that is on us. And as leaders, to lead the change, we need to bring that change to us. And as earlier Dr. Rita also pointed out, that we have enormous agency, all of us. We need to realize that and not put ourselves in silos. So being a person with a certain relationship doesn't mean we are anywhere less in some other facet. Being a wife does not detract from being a mother. Or being both of these does not detract from being a professional. And many a times in the past, women were delimited to these certain personal roles. But we see women have so much more in them to give. And when we talk of giving, it is what we have that we give. And to get the change in the world, we need to change ourselves. And as Rumi said yesterday, I was clever. So I wanted to change the world. But today I am wise. So I bring the change to myself. So when we are changing ourselves, we are a role model to others to follow our path. I run cyber helpline in India. It is a pan-India helpline. It's a free service for people to get addressal against cyber crimes. So this was the change that was brought upon us due to the pandemic. All of us were thrown online all of a sudden, and we did not know how to protect ourselves. We did not know what the IT laws were in the country, and the awareness was lacking. So when we see that there is a vacuum, there is a responsibility upon us to sort of try filling in that vacuum. So that is what delineates the leader, the doer from the general public. The leader takes it upon himself or herself to bring in that change, to see that change, to see the requirement, and then accordingly pivot. As in business terms, you say, we change ourselves and we rise up to that opportunity or the occasion. And to see that change, when we talk of that change, talking vacuously does not help. When we put ourselves in front and when we do what we say, when we put our actions to the words, when we put our actions to the ideas, we see the change. And then people realize that these are people who are doers. These are the leaders. And then they look up to us. And I am also a poet. I write bilingually. I'll just finish with just two lines. We had Victoria from Nigeria. Victoria, I think you would be aware of the term harambe. So it is har ambe, words used by the laborers there in colonial times, but it is a very pertinent term. So I would just say, ladies, do support other women and let's harambe. Harambe is coming together to support. Let's create an uplifting sisterhood urgently. And to create that sisterhood, this is the change I'm passionate about. The sisterhood, the voices of women. So I run a YouTube channel to promote women's voices. And happy to be here to be hearing your voices. And this is how I propagate change, by trying to see how I could fit in, how I could change myself to bring about that change and to highlight that change. And when we're highlighting change, we also need to highlight what is not needed. We also need to, apart from the positive, we need to highlight what we do not want. So that is the change that I see I would want to bring, and happy to be here. Thank you so much.
All right, ladies, that was a wonderful people presenting in terms of talking about the topics which was shared with them, and a wonderful genre of interactions which came in terms of thoughts from various locations. Someone talking about cancer specialization, healthcare, someone talking about startups, someone talking about education, someone speaking about cyber crimes that she's handling, Amesha talking about a little bit on a farm, what everything. All these ladies out here have a picture, and also with due respect, Victoria talking about her, you might say, struggles in Nigeria moving out and the violent protests which we have seen over the past years in terms of everyone getting a voice. Actually, the revolution in the Middle East was something which was unheard of, people standing up for their governments, and that has created a revolution amongst other countries also. Pros and cons, some are for the good, some who take advantage for their own undue purposes which are not needed. It should be a peaceful protest, not a violent one. Violence can never achieve anything. It can only achieve bloodshed, nothing more than that, and more hatred and more animosity. Thank you, ladies, for being a part of this lovely panel. You may take your seats. Tomorrow, if you could